Hi everyone, Travis with POSGuys.com. Today we are going to be configuring our Heron HD3100 or 3430 barcode scanner to do custom audio. So I'm going to walk you through the basic steps of how to do that. I have the Aladdin software launched already, and that is the software that you need to use in order to be able to upload audio to your device and configure which sounds to use. So my scanner is plugged in through a USB connection, and I'm going to do device auto detection. If you have not scanned the barcode for USB COM, you'll need to do that. You can get that barcode off of our website. Once you're in USB COM mode, you can click search for one device, and it's going to go through a couple of ports, but then it will locate your device. So it should take about 10 seconds. If it doesn't do it within 10 seconds or so, and you see a whole bunch of tested connections, then most likely you are not in USB COM mode, and you need to scan that barcode before continuing. Okay, once the device is detected, you can click the picture of it. So I have 3430 here. Click it. And your voice goes into programming mode. It'll become a solid green color on it, and you would have heard that beep. So in it, what you're going to need to do is you're going to need to upload the files, and then you're going to have to set which sounds. So under reading parameters, there is audio settings. By default, this is disabled, so it'll just use the regular beeps. If you enable it, then you can select your audio tones. The number here is the number of the file that you uploaded. How do you know that matches up? It's over here. There's a little note button, and if you click note, you're going to see these. So the one goes to shutter, two goes to dial tone, etc. So you can upload WAV files. There's a couple of notes on the WAV files. They need to be in 16-bit format. So by default, a lot of them are 32-bit. You can use Audacity, which is a free program, and you can pare down the file into a 16-bit version. Audacity is this program here, and I have a simple bird chirp going, and this bird chirp is an MP3 file. So what I'll want to do is go to File, Export Audio, and you'll have this choice here, either 16-bit or 32-bit. You want the 16-bit. And then you just save the file. I have it saved on my desktop, but I'll overwrite it. And then the file is ready for upload. So back in Aladdin, you click Browse. That was saved to my desktop, so I just select it. And then you click Download. If it's in the 32-bit format, you'll get an error right now. It'll say unrecognizable bit format. So switch from 32 and make it 17. Okay, so there we see our birds file. It is number 3, so you just got to remember number 3. I'm going to close this out. And I'm going to change my good read sound index to number 3. And then when I scan, we should hear the birds. So I'm going to write this to the scanner. And I'm going to go ahead and scan a barcode, and I'll put the scanner by the mic, and you should be able to hopefully hear some birds. So that's a successful programming of it. There's a few other audio sounds that you can do. Your power on sound, you can play a little jingle every time you plug in your scanner. You'll hear that. Enter stand mode. So if you're using the hands-free stand, when you put it into the stand, you can have it play an audio tone so that you know you are successfully in hands-free mode. Exit stand mode is the opposite. It puts into trigger mode. So you can take it out of the stand and hear sound. And there's an error indicator as well. so you can play a negative sound if you're doing something wrong. The audio tones are definitely useful for specialty stores, like this bird sound might be go well with a nature store of some sort, or dogs barking for like a pet store, something like that. You can get creative, but it definitely adds a unique touch to your store. So that's the basic overview on how you upload the sounds to your Heron barcode scanner. To download the Aladdin software, or for more information on programming your barcode scanner, please visit us at POSGuys.com. Thank you.